Welcome to the COD History Series, and today we're going to be counting down my picks for the 10 best sniper rifles in Call of Duty. Be sure to let me know which sniper is your favorite. Also, let me know which COD game you think has the best sniping mechanics. Before we get into this, guys, I want you to go check out the link at the top of the description. It is the Silent Gamer. That's all I'm going to say to you. Go check it out. If you enjoy it, sub up. Now let's get into it. Now, obviously, this is going to be a pretty random list because I'm not a very good sniper, but that's not to say that in the background when nobody's watching, I used a lot of sniper rifles. We can pretend, right? And at number 10, I'm going to go with the USR and Ghost. That's right. I'm going to go with the go-to sniper from that game. Now, Ghost was an average COD game at best, but if there was one thing it did really, really well, it was the sniping. The sniping in Ghost was excellent, largely thanks to how good the USR felt. This baby was the go-to gun for quick scoping, and there were tons and tons of great montages and 1v1s using it. I think it's the perfect way to kick off this list, and it's kind of a dark horse sniper. You don't usually hear about it when you hear about all the classic sniper rifles from COD history, so I wanted to show it some love. At number 9, and yes, I actually used this gun, the Moors in Advanced Warfare. Now, everybody knows AW was the first COD game of the Chet Pack era, and it got pretty mixed reception from the fans. Now, personally, I kind of liked it. I mean, honestly, there was a lot of things I did like it, a lot of things I didn't like it, but I can also admit there were a ton of problems with it. But hands down, the best sniper in the game was the Moors. This unique one-bullet sniper rifle was virtually always a one-hit kill, and it was the go-to gun for quick scoping and aggressive sniping. In a game like Advanced Warfare, where everybody is bouncing around and zipping around the map, getting a sniper hit marker can be extremely frustrating since hitting your shots is so difficult, and that is one of the main reasons people flocked to this gun, as you never had to worry about getting hit markers. You just lined up the shot, fired, and if you were in my case, fingers crossed, and you moved on to the next target. I have a little question for you. What was the go-to pistol that people would run as a secondary when they were using the Moors? Let me know in the comment section. At number 8, we have the DSR in Black Ops 2. Does anybody remember when Vaughn nerfed this thing? Now, I know people are kind of in the middle of the road with this gun after the legendary nerf. It's still more than deserving of a spot on the list, though. The DSR was originally insanely powerful thanks to its very quick fire rate, but after a while, Treyarch decided they had to tone it down a bit and nerf. They just nerfed it, guys. It wasn't actually that big of a nerf, but it was seen by many as the death of the gun entirely. People went nuts over this. I mean, DJ Vonderhard got death threats over this. But when you go play Black Ops 2 and use the gun, it's still an absolute beast even after the nerf. Now, the DSR hits extremely hard. It is almost always a one-shot kill. Plus, if you put FMJ on this bad boy, it will tear through the walls like paper, leading to some awesome wallbang clips and montages. I still love this thing. And while I totally agree that it was better before it was patched, it is still more than deserving of a spot on this list in its current state. At number 7, arguably the smoothest interacting sniper rifle is the M40A3 in COD 4. This is, well, people would argue this is where the sniping community in Call of Duty was born. Sure, there was sniping in earlier COD games and people made montages and all that good stuff, but it really wasn't until COD 4 that things really took off. The M40A3 is a bolt-action sniper in COD 4 that quickly became the go-to weapon for aggressive sniping thanks to its power, its speed, and its 5-shot capacity. Plus, when you put an ACOG scope on this baby, you actually got a damage increase. You heard me right, which would only encourage people to run around and get quick scoping, which they absolutely did. Now, you may argue that Modern Warfare 2 is really where the quick scoping and trick-shotting community blew up, and you may be right, but it was COD 4. It started it all, and the M40 is absolutely deserving of the number 7 spot on today's list. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 6, we're going to go with the Paladin in Black Ops 4. We don't usually put brand new stuff on here, and I'm sure you guys have been getting a little frustrated with the gun recently, and BO4 radically shook up the Call of Duty formula by increasing the time to kill and adding manual healing. And naturally, these changes, they made sniping a lot tougher since people could tank sniper body shots much easier than they could in previous COD games. And as a sniper, you need to have some really good accuracy for consistent one-shot kills. However, this didn't apply to the Paladin. The Paladin is the strongest sniper in Black Ops 4 by far and has very generous one-shot kill range, which in a game like BO4, that can be devastating. Now with other weapons, you need to be very precise with your aim in order to get your kills, but the Paladin is much more forgiving, especially if you throw on high caliber in FMJ. It's certainly frustrating to get dropped by the Paladin over and over in BO4, but frustration aside, I felt like it deserved a spot on the list. At number 5, we have the Locust in Black Ops 3. Now, BO3 is widely considered to be the best of the jetpack era COD games, and I agree with that. But when you have a game as dynamic and as fast-paced as BO3 was, in a game like COD where people love to snipe, it can be hard to create a weapon that encourages people to actually snipe, but still move around quickly. A lot of people in Black Ops 3 chose to sit still with the snipers due to how difficult sniping really was in that game. But chances are, if you were using the Locust, you were zipping around and playing very aggressively. The Locust is a sniper built for running and gunning and using Black Ops 3's movement to its fullest while also utilizing it. It had an extremely fast ADS time and a good rate of fire that could be made even faster with the rapid fire attachment and a very generous one-shot kill range. Plus, you could even put an ELO sight on it if you wanted to, if you felt like you were iron sniping, I guess. The Locust really was the ballista of Black Ops 3, and it deserves the number 5 spot. At number 4, the MSR in Modern Warfare 3. After Modern Warfare 2 had something as beastly as the Intervention, it was going to be hard for snipers of Modern Warfare 3 to live up the hype, but Infinity Ward and Sledgehammer put together an epic sniper in the form of the MSR. When you compare it to the Intervention, it is pretty much identical in its stats. It's not talked about as much, but it was. It was fast firing with godly firing sounds. It didn't hit super hard unless you had decent aim, which required you to get really good with it as opposed to just spamming. Kind of a sleeper pick for a lot of people, but then again, the people that used it, they knew how good it was. At number 3, and I never got good with this, but I loved trying, the Ballista in Black Ops 2. For many people, this was the best Call of Duty game ever. It was definitely one of the best COD games when it came to YouTube content, as people were doing commentaries and montages all over the place. One weapon you would constantly see in those montages was the Ballista, a very fast bolt-action sniper rifle that was the perfect weapon for quick scoping. Now, the Ballista had a fast aim-down sight time and a relatively quick rechamber time, a large magazine, and a one-shot kill range that wasn't too forgiving, but it forced you to get really good with the weapon if you were going to use it consistently. You couldn't just tag someone in the leg and kill them like you could with the DSR, and you couldn't spam someone like you could with the SVU. The Ballista was the perfect example of a COD gun that really took skill to use, and people absolutely loved it for that. Now this next one was almost my number one pick, the L96A1 in Black Ops 1. For those that weren't around in the beginning of Black Ops 1, let me give you a little history lesson. Sniping got nerfed hard in Black Ops due to Treyarch really not liking the prominence of quick scoping in Modern Warfare 2. This meant that sniping in Black Ops was going to be much harder due to awkward handling and lower damage that required you to get upper body shots for a kill or headshots if you were using a suppressor. But all the changes to the sniping also gave birth to a bolt-action sniper that was so insanely fun to use. I mean, it was the best sniper in the game by far. But after Treyarch eventually gave in and reversed the sniper nerfs, this thing was God gun. It was definitely the best sniper to use for playing aggressive as well as playing defensive and everything in between. And finally, there was no guessing here. You knew what number one was going to be for me. The Intervention. That's right, you guys knew it. The Intervention was the one and only bolt-action sniper in Modern Warfare 2, and it single-handedly gave birth to a massive community of quickscopers, trickshotters, and montage makers back in the day who still play this game to this day. The Intervention was fast-firing, it had a large mag, and it had an amazing fire sound that everybody remembers. It's super distinctive. When you look back at the base damage of this thing, it really wasn't anything special, if we're being honest, but with stopping power and some decent accuracy, it was absolutely unstoppable. For its performance in the game, as well as the impact it had on the COD community and the FPS genre as a whole, the Intervention gets the number one spot on today's list for me. And there you go, guys. That is my personal list of the 10 best snipers in COD history. If I forgot one, let me know which one it should be, or let me know your personal list in the comment section. Drop a like. Make sure you're subscribed. We do a new COD History Top 10 every Wednesday and every Sunday. If you have suggestions for future ones, remember, these are all my personal list. Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you guys soon.